Day, sunshine. How are you? How are you? I'm so happy you stopped by. I'm getting ready for bed. I'm getting ready for bed. Do you want me to help you get ready for bed? I'm gonna start by cleaning off your face. You should always go to bed with a nice clean face, so none of that muck sets in overnight. Just some facial cleansers, okay? They're very mild, and they're not scented, and they're great for sensitive skin, okay? Just in case you need that. Unscented. It's very gentle. All right. Are you ready? Are you ready? Okay. I'm just gonna wipe. Wipe. Wipe it all away. Wipe it all away. Mm-hmm. Nice circular motions around, 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 just wiping all of it away. There. Nice and cool. It's nice and cool against your skin. Look up. Look up for me. Look up. Up. And I'm gonna get just right under your eye. Then we can go right under this eye. Relax your eyes again. I'm just gonna go right here on your forehead. Back and forth. Back and forth. And then right down your nose. And into those little nooks. Those little nooks and crannies. cheek. We'll do this cheek now. Your chin. Your chin. And now lift your head up for me. Lift your head up. And we're just gonna do right under there. And your neck. It's all an extension of your face. And we're just gonna take all of that build up away. Dry. Let that dry just a little. Okay. Just a little. And then we'll take a moisturizer. Smell. It's a very light scent. It's a very light scent. And we'll just take a little. Just take a little. And this will leave your skin feeling silky smooth. Your nose, your chin, there, and lift your head up so we don't forget your neck, there you go, gonna use the extra on my hands. You should also brush your hair before you go to bed. Soft. It'll be less tangly. Do you want me to brush your hair? Okay. Let's brush your hair. This is my pink brush. It's had better days. But it still gets the job done. Are you ready, sunshine? Okay. And we'll brush. And brush. And brush your hair. Get all the tangles out. Just leave it silky smooth. Brush. Brush. Your hair, brush, brush, brush your hair, so it feels so silky. There you go, sunshine. How does it feel? How does it feel? Run your fingers through it. What's that? A bedtime story? I can do that. How about the hare and the tortoise? Here they are right here. Classic. Our cute little tortoise right here. And our little hare. Lazily sleeping under the leaves. This book has lots of stories, but I'm gonna read you the title story, The Hare and the Tortoise, okay? Reading to all these adorable little mice. Picture me as the kitten, and you are my little mouse. Okay. Once upon a time, a conceited hare challenged a long-suffering tortoise to an absurd race. And, incredible though it may seem to you, this is the story. Once upon a time, there was a hare who, boasting how he could run faster than anyone else, was forever teasing a tortoise for its slowness. Then one day, the irate tortoise answered back, "Who do you think you are? There's no denying you're swift, but even you can be beaten." The hare squealed with laughter. "Beaten in a race? By whom? Not you, surely. I bet there's nobody in the world that can win against me. I'm so speedy. Now why don't you try?" Annoyed by such bragging, the tortoise accepted the challenge. A course was planned, and the next day at dawn, they stood at the starting line. The hare yawned sleepily as the meek tortoise trudged slowly off. When the hare saw how painfully slow his rival was, he decided, half asleep, on his feet to have a quick nap. "Take your time," he said. "I'll have 40 winks and I'll catch up with you in a minute." The hare woke with a start from a fitful sleep and gazed around, looking for the tortoise. But the creature was only a short distance away, having barely covered a third of the course. Breathing a sigh of relief, the hare decided he might as well have breakfast too, and off he went to munch on some cabbages he had noticed in a nearby field. But the heavy meal and the hot sun made his eyelids droop. With a careless glance at the tortoise, now halfway along the course, he decided to have another snooze before flashing past the winning post. And smiling at the thought of the look on the tortoise's face when it saw the hare speed by, he fell fast asleep and was soon snoring happily. The sun started to sink below the horizon, and the tortoise, who had been plodding towards the winning post since morning, was scarcely a yard from the finish line. At that very point, the hare woke with a jolt. He could see the tortoise a speck in the distance, and away he dashed. He leapt and bounded at a great rate, his tongue lolling and gasping for breath. Just a little more and he'd be first at the finish. But the hare's last leap was just too late, for the tortoise had beaten him to the winning post. Poor hare. Tired and in disgrace, he slumped down beside the tortoise, who was silently smiling at him. "Slowly does it every time," he said. The end. And there's the little hare, being lazy and sleepy. And there is our tortoise, winning the race. I hope you enjoyed that story, Sunshine. Because now it's time we part ways for this evening. Maybe I'll read you another story sometime. Before you go, take a glass of water in case you need it. And as always, I hope that wherever you are, whatever time it may be, you are safe, you are happy, very, very